Hey friends, TUXX here. For this particular video, I have one of the more strange and awesome things I've unboxed in a while. And the reason why I say it's strange and awesome is because I don't really know what this is, okay? This is a handheld video game device. This is part of actually my Christmas haul. And it's been kind of a Christmas tradition in our household for me to receive every year some kind of strange Chinese knockoff, weird emulation tool video game thing, okay? And it's fun because I do collect these strange little things. I mean, it could be as simple as finding a little, like, 2,000 video games at Walgreens and a little controller, or like a classic arcade game and like more of a Namco like branded controller or something. But this one is definitely a mystery to me. This one is, I'm being told it can play MAME, okay? And if you're not familiar with what MAME is, it's arcade emulation, okay? And just going back to about 2004, 2003, I guess it was, probably around 2003, I built myself an arcade cabinet. It was actually a cocktail-style arcade machine using, like, just, I start with, like, a few sheets of plywood shipped to me from the lumberyard and some tools, and then, of course, special, you know, instructions. I followed them to the T and made, like, a replica-perfect arcade machine with graphics and coin mechs and everything, and it played arcade games, and it was really cool. And it was great, but it wasn't really so portable, okay? And what's great about this is this apparently has games on it, and you can actually add games to it or delete games, okay? This kind of strikes me as probably something that maybe has, like, foreign games on it or something, but we're going to find out together in this video. I'm going to stop yabbering about this and just get to this unboxing. This is what the box looks like. Video games, and it has this PSP-looking device, okay? It looks pretty cool. From the box, looks like it plays movies, connects with USB, how it plays music, takes photos, everything. So that is pretty cool. The side here looks like I have the black model, and this particular box is marked either being 2G, 4G, 8G, or 16G, which obviously is gigabytes, but I don't have a marking here, so I don't know what this one is, like, memory-wise. Here on the side, this is video games. On the back here, it's got some little features. You can pause that if you want to check it out, but basically, it talks about different resolutions. Basically, it talks about music formats it supports, which is a lot. Talks about different things about taking photos, different video formats, just all the little fine detail in very, very small print, okay? And this, I'm not even sure where this was purchased from, to be honest with you. It was probably purchased online. Maybe it was something that can be purchased on eBay. I tried investigating this Christmas gift a little bit, and I came up dry, guys. I could not figure out where this thing was purchased from, okay? And it was a gift, so I'm not going to dig too deep into it, but it looks really cool. So we're going to open this right now. Let's go ahead and see what is inside the box. I love old arcade games, and MAME, if you're into it or curious about it, it's not just old. I mean, it can play, like, Mortal Kombat and Street Fighter 2, and it's not just classic, like, Asteroids or whatever, you know? It plays more modern games, so it's really great, and they keep adding more and more games to what MAME can actually play. Okay, so inside the box here, we have a USB cord, it looks like, so it's great that it does come with a cord. The cord is not braided, and I wouldn't really expect it to be honest with you. But it's kind of a short little cord here. Looks like it's a standard. Oh, this is the older style USB, which is interesting. You can see it's a larger style to a straight up USB plug. Okay, so this is how you connect it to your computer to charge it, I believe, and also is a means to use data, put different data on it. Now, I believe this has a SIM card slot. Let's see here. Oh, let's see. It does come with headphones, so very cool. Kind of like PSP, just a little typical earbud kind of thing, but it's nice that it includes that. Never can have too many headphones. And here is instructions. Let's see, this is called MP5. Interesting. The MP5. Okay, I guess I could try and look that up and see if that somehow is something I can purchase somewhere. When I see this, I think of, like, MP3 or whatever, but it's very interesting. Let's see. Thank you for purchasing our digital products before opening this unit. Please read the manual thoroughly. I mean, wow, you're asking a lot because there's a lot of fine print on this manual on fairly light paper. This paper is very thin, almost like tissue paper. So good luck reading this whole thing. But it does have some pretty detailed instructions here. You can see from everything from viewing it to playing music and movies. You guys know I hate reading manuals, so I'm not going to sit here and read through the whole manual. We'll just have to learn from experimenting, and I can always come back to the manual if something something doesn't make sense. But anyway, it looks pretty cool, and it has a pretty good manual for something which is probably like a little Chinese knockoff machine. Okay, and here it is. Wow, that looks just like a PSP. So if you were a kid, okay, and if you, back in the days of PSP, and if you're like, man, I really wish I had a PSP, and your folks couldn't afford you a PSP, this could be like a Chinese knockoff of that. Now, the games themselves, I don't really know if they're PSP or not. It even has a circle that makes it look like a PSP, but it's not. I'm going to grab a PSP. Let's take a look and compare. Okay, so here's a PSP. This isn't the original launch PSP. This is one later. This is one of the models that came like a few years down the road, like the kind of PSP 2.0 or whatever. And this is what this looks like. So you can see it is pretty similar to a PSP. It's really modeled after the classic original launch PSP. The weight of it does feel light. I wouldn't say it feels a whole lot lighter than a PSP, though, to be honest with you. This is pretty light in its own right, the real PSP. As far as the screen goes, definitely fingerprint magnet. I just have a peel off here, so that will make it look even shinier and better. Sorry for the glare, guys. Just have a nice glossy black plastic, like a paint job to it, which is definitely a fingerprint magnet. On the bottom here, it looks like there is a small slot for a SIM card, so that's good. On the back side here, it does have some interesting things, actually. It has on-off switch, which isn't too interesting. But then it does have this here, a TV in and TV out. That just interests me a lot. Although, I want to say it's more like headphones, but headphones, TV out? Kind of phrased weird. USB and a microphone. It does have a camera right here. Okay, so it looks like this is a 10.0 megapixel camera, which that alone is not half bad for being like a Chinese knockoff product, to be honest with you. And that is pretty much it. Okay, these are not, looks like it does have like the PSP little, see how it has like a little hanger there? It does have that little hanger here so you can belt loop it or something if you like. And let's see if I can actually power this bad boy on. It probably does not have batteries. It does not take batteries, so it must need charging. I'm going to charge this, and we'll be right back. Okay, so we gave it a little bit of a charge here, and you can see there is a blue light here indicating power. I know the light here is probably kind of glaring that out a little bit. We'll go ahead and turn this on, or try to. And there we go. So actually, I'm going to need to dim the lights here. Let me go ahead and dim it, and we'll take a look at these games. We'll be right back. Okay, we're back, and I have to say, I am impressed. This has some pretty great-looking games. I almost want to say this looks very PlayStation, like this may, this might almost be like a fake PlayStation, but then look at these games. Up here, there's a Mario, it's something called Super Mario. This looks pretty incredible here. Mario up in the upper left-hand corner. Let's go ahead and hit this and see what happens. Oh, that's weird. Oh, Super Mario, look at that. That looks pretty awesome. And it even has copyright 1985 Nintendo. Okay, this is like a super bootleg here, man. This actually has like the copyright on the bootleg. You know Nintendo would not authorize making this. Let's go ahead and try a one-player game and see what happens here. All right, this looks pretty good, guys. It's kind of hard to see it maybe in the darkness of the room. And the screen looks a little bit dark, but not bad. Oh no, okay. Well, you get the idea, guys. That looks pretty darn good. I am quite impressed with the way this looks. All right, let's go ahead and go out. We'll go ahead and quit. So it's interesting, it actually has old games like that. Now looking at these, it has Contra, Battle Cry, King of Fighters it looks like, which is Neo Geo, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Dragon Ball, Tekken. This, wow, it's great, Tekken. Some kind of space shooter, lightning plan, Final Fight, Metal Slug, Crash Bandicoot. Oh my god, okay. Street Fighter. And it probably has more. Let me kind of go over here. Is that it for the games? Those are some pretty great games, I have to admit. Let's go over here to Game Center. We'll hit this. Let's see, classic games. Games on demand. I guess it breaks it down to 32-bit and 8-bit. We'll do 32 here and see what happens. See, it says GBA Game Boy Advance. That's interesting. Let me go ahead and load and see what that's all about. I have no idea here, guys. Licensed by Nintendo. Okay, that sounds like Game Boy. EA Games. Wow, okay. It's amazing they actually have, like, the copyrighted, like, splash screens. And there it is. Pretty great graphics, though, man. I mean, I think this is better than NES. Alright, yes, this is like classic Road Rash, which is great. Alright, let's see what this is. Oh, wow, Galaxian. This is like Nintendo Galaxian for NES. This is kind of like the classic NES, but... Okay, I have to say this is probably the best classic, like, knockoff emulator I've ever seen, actually. This is actually really nice. Let's try, like, one of these games on the front screen here. We'll try Tekken 3. Tekken 3, that actually doesn't go back as far as it probably could have. This is probably going to look really good. Namco, looks good so far. This looks like classic PlayStation Tekken. Like PlayStation 1 Tekken. Maybe a little choppier. But not bad, though. Not bad at all. So, God, I have to say that all in all, I'm pretty impressed with this. Let's check out some of the other features real quick, too, just in case. Looks like it has music player. I wonder if it's full of, like, J-pop music or something. Let's see here. Probably doesn't have anything. Oh, my God, it does have some music. Oh, it has Psy. Okay, that's funny. This is probably Gundam style or something. Let's see. All right, friends, to wrap it up, this is a pretty cool little device. This, of course, is this little gaming system, and I guess it's called the X6, according to the little icon right there. Hopefully you can see that little X6. And, I mean, the fact that it has Mario Brothers on it, it has, you know, Tekken, it's a little with King of Fighters, it has Gundam Style, the song on it. I mean, so many different commercial licensed things from Sony, Nintendo, you know, Neo Geo, just all over the board. It's actually a really cool little device. So I have to say, this is an awesome Christmas gift. I am definitely pleased with this. And if you're into game emulation, if you're into putting your own flash card in there and actually loading this to the gill with movies and music and stuff, it's a great little device. So it can do a lot of things. If you have any questions about this device, please let me know here in the comments below, and I'll be happy to answer them. But I have to say, for the fact that it, you know, it plays music and it does movies and it plays, you know, games from a variety of different classic systems, that's pretty cool in my book. So I want to thank you guys for watching this video. Be sure and check out TUXX Toys on Instagram and Twitter, TUXX Reviews also on Instagram and Twitter, and there's some great gaming hardware stuff on Instagram and Twitter for TUXX Reviews too. If you go back, some of my earliest, like, hardware reviews for gaming devices are on TUXX Reviews, okay? All right, friends, we'll talk to you soon.